Hi, we're Glass Vegas, and this is Whiskey Soda TV.
You just got here from Denmark, Paul just told me, mm-hmm. and you were, I think, touring with Oasis just
yeah, a month ago or something, 2 months ago,
about two months.
So yeah. Probably the big halls and big sting.
I think it was 12, 14, 16,000. Yeah, pretty big halls. Just a couple of little shows.
So you're glad to be back in the smaller clubs.
It's always good to do your own shows. Mm. You know, it's an honour to support someone like Oasis, obviously. Mm. But it's always better to do your own shows.
And next, I guess, I think U2 and so on.
Yes.
Yeah. Bit scary, maybe.
A little bit.
We haven't played in stadiums before. Mm. So this will be a first.
Isn't it a bit strange to... I could imagine to play a song like I Know Daddy's Gone, which is a bit personal from James' perspective, and to sing it in front of, I don't know, what you said, 12,000 or 40,000 people, and doesn't it feel a bit weird, and people singing along, and...
Yeah, it does, but it's...
It's wonderful.
Yeah. It's wonderful?
Yeah, we're very lucky that we have that. It's a really good feeling. And it's weird as well, people react lots of different ways to it. You can have someone crying, and right next to them, someone jumping around. So it's everyone seems to enjoy it.
That's really great. And Daddy's Gone is also the next single that's going to come out in Germany now.
Oh, yeah. Oh.
And like all of your singles, they're also coming out on vinyl. Is that something that's just some, I don't know, old... fashioned romantic thing you like, or is it?
Absolutely, vinyl is amazing. You can't beat the sound of vinyl.
I think it's James doesn't have very good eyesight. The bigger we can make the CDs, the easier we can see them.
Yeah, I think it's nice in a time where a lot of bands just want to release. No, we only release MP3s now in the internet, so that's some kind of.
We're the other way. Our first two singles we done ourselves, mm-hmm. was always vinyl. We only made vinyl, and I think it's got a certain romance to it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's nostalgic.
Called the Arctic Monkeys.
But still, the internet is too an important, I know, tool to.
And
you use that too, I think. Do you think that's?
Yeah.
Is that I don't know, something you have to do, or is it?
If a record company could make money branding horses with their lyrics, they would do it. So they use whatever means they have to make any money. But the internet's a big tool now. So many people just download from iTunes and stuff like that.
Yeah.
So,
that's not something you're fanatically into and like to keep up the new stuff.
On tour, it's easier because I have lost about 100 CDs on the bus.
Yeah. Oh.
You take a CD wallet and leave it in a venue. So iTunes, you don't forget your laptop. You never forget your computer.
Well, James does.
James does.
You recorded a Christmas EP last year in Transylvania.
Mm.
How was that? And how did that idea come up?
The idea was James's. It's just one of these wacky ideas that James has, and because we're in a band, we can make it happen. It was bizarre. It was beautiful. It was interesting. You know.
And you recorded in a cathedral.
Or? Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Wow, that's really amazing. Like
it was,
an old Dracula movie. Or
yeah, well, we went to Bran Castle,
mm-hmm.
which is where Vlad the Impaler, who inspired Dracula, was that was his castle. And it was so gothic and very, very creepy.
Yeah.
But we drove for an hour to have photos took.
Mm-hmm.
When we got there, and it was actually a girl from Berlin taking photos.
Mm-hmm.
But she didn't want to take any.
Of like the castle?
We drove for an hour to this beautiful castle. No, it's not right. it's a beautiful place. And very gothic too.
Yeah.
It's probably good for a Christmas album.
Yeah, it was quite an atmospheric place. And I think it was the right place to record that piece of music.
And the topic of Christmas, how did that, I don't know, come up? Because Christmas albums, I don't know, you associate it with, I don't know, older bands or some boring old classic rock type of bands, I don't know.
I think James just wanted to get across what his memories of Christmas were,
mm-hmm.
and how things can change from year to year,
mm-hmm.
In people's lives. And one thing in Britain, you get a lot of time off at Christmas,
yeah.
and sometimes it puts a strain on people. But he wanted to make this. Although it's a Christmas EP, it's an extension of the album.
Mm-hmm.
It's songs that we still play just now. So it's weird. No one's. Maybe in years to come, people will realise that we released like an album and a half in
mm-hmm.
4 months.
Mm-hmm.
And it was quite an achievement.
Do you also play the cover versions live sometimes? Because
occasionally.
I really like your version of Come As You Are.
We've really never played that live.
No.
We did start working on it in America, but kind of things,
mm-hmm.
the amount of press and that took over and cut our time down.
Mm-hmm.
But that was a great. James went in and done it in a day, and it was all kind of put down in a day, and it was really quite surprising.
Yeah, it's an interesting idea to re-record that modern classic. It's really cool. And I heard now the next record you maybe were going to record in LA, mm-hmm. is that true?
Yeah.
How did that get to you? Is that any special?
I think James just went and really loved LA.
Mm-hmm.
I have a special thing for New York. James's place is LA.
Okay.
Blue skies and, you know.
Yeah.
Sunshine. Why not?
It's not what you first associate with your
type
of music style, the California sunny side.
The second album will be Hawaiian shots.
Yeah.
Shots like that. Summer.
It's all about surfing.
And, I don't know, surf punk or whatever. And do you feel like there's any pressure on you for the second album? Because now there were a lot of very positive reviews and so on in the press, and do you feel there's any kind of pressure on you for the second album, or don't you care about that?
No, any kind of pressures we feel are ones that we put on ourselves from having like high expectations of ourselves or of each mm-hmm. other. External pressures don't really affect us.
Okay. So it's more important to keep the, I don't know, the interactions in the band working and fulfilling
and
one's own
everything else.
Expectations. Yeah,
yeah. Everything else will fall into place.
But could you imagine, I don't know, recording a second record that's completely different style than the first one? Because I think a lot of people now really associate the name Las Vegas with this certain style you had on the EP and also on the...
I think it will be very different to the first.
Mm-hmm.
I think it's going to sound like nothing else. James certainly doesn't want it to sound like the first album
mm-hmm.
either, so he's really... Not that we're not proud of it, but that's been done. That's back there,
mm-hmm.
and now we're looking towards the future.
We're different people now. We've got different experiences. James has seen different things. He's, you know, where his head's at.
Mm-hmm.
It's a different place. So people move on and progress, and I'm sure the music will as well.
And in one interview you gave in German newspaper, I read that maybe tomorrow you may be dead, you said.
It's true, at the minute, I might be.
No, I don't mean you as a person. I mean the band, actually. Is that still? I don't know.
If one of us didn't want to do it, and mm-hmm. I think we'd have the decency to walk away from it. And I think, well, it would probably be the end of Las Vegas.
But
I'd say probably if it was me. I am referred to as someone sent a message on MySpace saying to Rab James and the other two. So that made me feel very, very peripheral.
We're the glue, the glue.
James and Rab are the PlayStation 3 and we're the controllers. We're like, that's fucked, we'll buy another one.
Okay, so I don't think it's going to happen. You don't expect it to happen then?
I hope not, I've just bought a TV.
Okay, so what are your next plans now for the immediate future? Just finishing the tour, and I heard you play with U2, we always said, and
yeah.
Kings of Leon, and
yeah, we've got lots of gigs. We're kind of mm-hmm. booked up right until the end of October. Like you say, we're supporting U2 mm-hmm. and some stadium gigs. We are going back to America after this tour. Kings of Leon, lots and lots of festivals. And then album time.
Album time, great. Yeah, thanks a lot for the interview.
No problem.
It was a pleasure.